Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we'll look at mocking up our designs in Photoshop, and I'm using a couple of Design Cuts resources for this video. So let's see what we're going to be using. I'll use an element from the clothing, fashion and t-shirt mockups, and also an element from coffee stationery branding mockups. These mockups are handy because they're nice and clean. They're going to save you a lot of time working in Photoshop. Just a word before we get started here, the files that I'm working from have a whole lot of elements in them pre-prepared to make it easy for you to create your mockups. But we're going to ignore these for one reason, and that is that sometimes you don't get files that look this good. Sometimes somebody might just send you an image of a t-shirt or a dress or something that you're supposed to work with. And so I'm going to show you how you can create mockups even if the file has nothing in it designed to help you do your mockups faster. So you're going to learn techniques that are going to help you with any project at any time. So I already have the clothing shoes accessories.psd file open. I have the move tool selected and auto select selected because I want to just click on this t-shirt. That's the one I'm going to use. I'm going to take it to a brand new document. I can do that from the layers palette here. We'll just ascertain which layer this is. Well, it's an entire group here. So I'll right click the group and choose duplicate group. Here I can select a new document and I can put this into a brand new document. So I'm going to call this t-shirt and click OK. And this creates a brand new document with just the t-shirt in it. I'm going to crop it so that it's just sized down to the t-shirt size. And let's go back to the clothing, shoes and accessories PSD file and just close that because we don't need it any longer. Over here in the layers palette, I'll control click on the new layer icon to add a layer beneath everything else. And because white is my background color, I will press control backspace. That would be command delete on the Mac to fill that background layer or that bottom layer with white. And I'm going to lock it down. I'll press control or command zero to zoom in so that we can see the t-shirt clearly. Now, depending on how many lumps and bumps your t-shirt has got in it, or any fabric element, for example, has got in it, you may want to use some of these lumps and bumps to sort of bend your art. Now, this t-shirt, we could probably get away without doing that, but let's see how we would do it if we wanted to. The first thing we need to do is to convert this into grayscale. So I'm going to grab the t-shirt layer because I know the background is white because I made it white. We're not quite sure about the t-shirt color. So let's choose layer, new adjustment layer, and choose black and white and just click OK. And that just converts this to black and white. We're going to use this as a bump map, as a map for sort of bending our artwork. And to do that, we need to be working with a black and white image. We also need to save this as a PSD file. So I'll choose file and then save as. I'm going to call this t-shirt bump map. It has to be a PSD file and I'll just click save. Now I can get rid of my black and white adjustment layer because I don't need that any longer. And let's go and get our art. The art I'm going to be using is this retro car, and I've already isolated it from its background. So I'll select the layer that has the content in it and we're going to copy it across into the t-shirt file. So I'll right click the layer here and choose duplicate layer, and then I can just go and send it to the t-shirt file, which is called t-shirt bump map now because we saved as a bump map. So I'm just going to click OK, and over here we can now place the image roughly in position and obviously holding the shift key if we're going to resize it to place it in the correct position at the correct size. Now at this stage, if you wanted to be super careful, you would choose file and then save as and go and save this as t-shirt. Just so that you don't destroy the bump map file and you don't confuse this for a bump map file. Now, to use the bump map file to actually distort our image, what we're going to do is to select the image and apply a distort filter to it. Now, you can do this with or without converting for smart filters. It's probably better to convert for smart filters, so I'll choose filter and then convert for smart filters and click OK. And now to apply our bump map, we'll go to Filter and then Distort and choose Displace. At this point, we need to specify a horizontal and vertical scale. I'm setting mine to 10 and I have Stretch to Fit and Repeat Edge Pixel selected. I'll click OK. And now we'll go and get the bump map that I just saved, which is this t-shirt bump map, and click Open. And you'll see that the image moved a little bit. Let's zoom in and see what's happening. And I'll turn the Displace filter off. The image is going to move where there were black or darker areas in the original bump map. So we would probably see some slight distortion of the image at this point. And there is a very subtle distortion. As I said, if you had a t-shirt with a lot of wrinkles in it, then this image would be quite distorted, and you would want it to be slightly distorted because it's being placed on a wrinkly t-shirt. There are other things that we can do to reinforce the suggestion that this image is actually part of the t-shirt rather than having been just plonked on top of it. One of them is to slightly decrease the opacity of this layer. I'll generally take mine down to probably around 95%, and that does help to sort of settle the image in position. The other thing that we can do is to borrow the lights and darks from the t-shirt part that is underneath the car. So let's go to this layer, because this is the sort of t-shirt layer, if you like. This is the lights and darks. And let's borrow a copy of this. I'll drag and drop it onto the new icon so I get a second copy, and I'm going to walk this all the way up to the very top of the image. Now, the blend mode for this is linear burn. That's not what we want for this effect at this point of the image. What we want is something like multiply. And then, because this image is currently affecting the entire t-shirt, we're going to clip it. So we'll go to this layer and choose layer and then create clipping mask. And that will clip the effect to just the car. So you'll see when I turn this on and off that the color effect, the darkening, is only being applied to the car and not to the rest of the t-shirt. And if it's too dark an effect, then you can just walk the opacity down a little bit. Just make it a little less opaque. But it still is going to be spot darkening the image in the places where the t-shirt was darker in the first place. So that's a way of applying an image to a t-shirt. Let's have a look now at applying it to something that is bending and how we're going to achieve that. Let's look now at a couple of elements here from the Coffee Stationery mockup PSD file. I'm going to grab this sleeve and I'm going to use this coffee cup. So first of all, let's grab the sleeve. We'll go to the layers palette, locate the layer that it is on. Again, it's in a group, right click and choose duplicate group. And I'm just going to call this sleeve. So I'm creating a brand new document for it. And we'll go and do the same thing with the coffee cup. I'm going to select the largest of these coffee cups. I can now close the stationery mockup because I don't need that any longer. I'll crop each of these images to size, and we're going to look at how we would get our image onto these elements. Again, I'm going to bring in my retro car. So in each of these images, the coffee cup and the sleeve, my car has been added. Let's start with the sleeve. This image is obviously way too big for the sleeve element I'm trying to put it on. So I'll press Ctrl T and then Ctrl 0, and that will size the image so I can see the handles. Holding the Shift key down, I'm going to size and place my car in position, making sure that I'm always adjusting it from a corner with the Shift key so that it's constrained to its original proportions, because I don't want to destroy my art as I'm working. I'll add a new layer to the bottom of the image. Well, it hasn't gone in place, but let's go and move it there in just a second. I'll fill it with white with Control or Command Backspace, and let's just move the sleeve above it so we can see everything a little more clearly. I'll just lock down that layer so it doesn't move. What we'll want to do with our car now is to bend it so that it looks a little bit better on this sleeve. So to bend it, we have a warp tool in Photoshop. I'll choose Edit and then Transform, and I'll go to Warp. Now I could use a custom warp on this, but there's probably a warp here that would do it for me. So let's go to the warp drop-down list, and arc or arch are probably going to give me the results I'm looking for. I'll start with arc. Obviously this is too much of an effect, but I can change the bend value up here. I'll take it down to 10%, and that's been a pretty good result. It's bent the image across the sleeve, so it looks a bit better. I'll just click the check mark because I'm happy with that result. I'll move the car into position. Now you might notice here that this side of the sleeve is just a little bit darker than this side over here. So let's see how we would adjust our image to take that into account. I'll hold the Alt or Option key as I click here on the new layer icon. That allows me to specify things about this new layer. What I'll do is set its blend mode to soft light and click here to fill it with a soft neutral light color, 50% gray. I'll click OK. Now you can see that this has had no effect on the image at all. What it is what's going to be called a dodge and burn layer. 50% gray just doesn't affect an image at all if it's applied in soft light blend mode. But that means I can go and get the dodge and burn tools. The burn tool will darken things. So I have it set to the range of midtones. The exposure is quite low at 15%. I think that's probably too much. I'll set it to 7%. I have a nice soft brush here. You can see that the hardness is zero. The size is probably a little on the small side, 90 pixels. I'll just enlarge it using the close square bracket key. With this layer selected, I'm going to just brush across the area of the image that I want to darken a little bit, this side of the image. I can then go to the Dodge tool, which is a lightening tool, do something similar, set midtones, because these colors are pretty much in the midtone area, to an exposure of 7% here, and I'll just brush over this area of the image, which is going to lighten it a little bit. And you'll see that we've got light and dark areas here being applied in this Dodge and Burn layer. But of course, the dodge and burn that we're applying is going to be filtering through across the car, but also in the places where the car is not visible, they're going to be affecting the coffee sleeve underneath. Well, again, I want to limit this to only the car. So with this layer selected, I'll choose layer and then create clipping mask. And that adjusts the dodge and burn effect only to the car layer. And if it's too much, I can just dial down the opacity. When we turn this layer on and off, you'll see that there's a slight darkening of the image. Again, trying to reinforce that this image has been applied to the sleeve and isn't just plonked on top. Let's have a quick look at the coffee cup. We're just going to have a look at it for the purposes of discussing what we're going to do with it. Again, I'll resize it. I'm just going to place it in position on the cup. Let's zoom in here. We would do something very similar with the car here, so far as dodging and burning it. This cup is obviously really light on this side, really dark on this side, and we'll want to reflect that in the image itself. But when an image like this is applied to a surface like this coffee cup, if we were to have a look at the coffee cup, we would see that it would be sort of squashed up. The image would be squashed up a bit here and here and stretched out a little bit across the middle of the cup. That's the visual that we're going to get. So what we would do with this is select the layer and again choose Edit and then Transform, and then choose Warp, and this time we'll use the Warp Mesh. So what we'll do is slightly stretch the middle part of the car here, and that will squeeze up the left third of the car. Now you'll obviously spend a lot more time doing this than I am, but you'll just adjust the car so it's going to be a little bit more squashed up as it bends around the edge of the cup here. And we're going to do the same on this side. Now the car was a little bit wider on this side, so I'll get a bit of mileage by just bringing it in here, so that'll squash up the right third of the car a little bit, and then we can just bring over these points. I'm just dragging on the intersection of these lines. They're points that I can drag on. Now I would be looking for a straighter line than this. I just want to give you an impression of what it is that you're going to do. You can also drag on these handles here if you need to curve the bottom of the image just a little bit, but again, you'll spend more time on this than I am. I'm just giving you an indication as to what I would be doing here to make the car look like it's bent around the cup a little bit better. And of course, drop on that 50% gray filled soft light blend mode layer and then dodge and burn this. So again, it looks more like it's been applied to the cup than just plonked on as an image. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.